Joker.
Yeah!
pardon the intrusion, Clan Mother, but we bring distressing news.
You speak of Brightholme, yes? And the death of Hizuni.
You already know?
This one heard whispers on the wind. May Kenarthi carry her to sweeter sons. Though Tidali consents the whims of death, she is blind to your motives. Tell this one, Dragon Guard, why have you come? Yes, this temple cared for Jadari's remains long ago. You seek the halls of the Hymen, a most sacred place. Its secrets have been passed down across the ages. Though perhaps that tradition has died with Hizuni. Even if Rokajin finds the mask, it would reject him. He will never be worthy of its power. She did. Then perhaps Hizuni saw something in the tapestry of time that this one has yet to hear in the wind. Very well. Seek the statue of the Forgotten Mane south of this temple. Just listen for the bells. You will find a bell stand by the statue, much like the one in our temple's courtyard. After so many years of neglect, Tidali is sure the bells are heavily tarnished. You should very well. Ask what you will, Dragon Guard. You know of Rokajin, yes? He was trained from a young age to enter the Pride of Alkosh. Upon his death, he was to join Alkosh in a place beyond the sands, behind the stars. But that was not Rakajin's only destiny. In times of great need, Rokajin was trained to obtain the Divine Mask from the halls of the Hymen. Through grueling trials and tests of will, he would prove himself worthy. And then he decided to become a Dragon Priest. Youth these days.
The Halls of the Hymen. Sounds rather ominous, doesn't it? I don't think this will be a simple jaunt through some ruins. Let's just hope Rokajin doesn't find the mask first. Yes, I know the statue. Zaji and I passed by it the last time we were in Black Heights. It seemed to unsettle him, but he wouldn't tell me why. Well, no time to ask him now. I'll meet you by the statue. Of course I want to go with you. You'll need assistance, won't you? I know that I might not be the strongest of the Dragon Guard, or the most experienced, or even the most resourceful. Trust me, I'm aware of my shortcomings, but I can still help. I'm sorry, it's just, I can't help but feel like I've let you all down. Yagrandu was dead by the time we arrived. Could I have done something to find him sooner? And Koska helped you find the Order of the New Moon, not me. And my father. It may not sound reasonable, but I can't help it. It's easy to doubt myself after so many failures. That's why I want to come with you. I want to do something right. I want to prove that I'm worthy of the title Dragon Guard.
Thank you.
These bells look just like the ones in Kanarthi's Breath Temple. And look, they're all tarnished. Clan Mother Tidali was right. The bells are tarnished from neglect. Why don't we perform the cleansing ritual? You just need to press the pedal there to start it. I imagine it will be similar to how you cleanse the bells in Kanarthi's Breath Temple. The small bells glow in a certain order. All you need to do is hit the larger bells nearby in the same order. That should cleanse them. We need to hit the big bells in the same order as the little bells. They should be around here somewhere. Are cleansed.
Indeed, they are. Well done. Come, Dragon Guard. Tidali must prepare you for the trials ahead. Kanarthi calls to you with gentle winds. She can guide you, but never carry you. With cunning, with speed, you must find your own way. Do you accept Kanarthi's blessing? The drums of Lorkaj beat strongly. Darkness creeps into your heart, and death claws at your throat. With strength, with courage, you must find the light. Will you face Lorkaj's darkness? Elkosh watches with a steady eye. His wayward children have forgotten their purpose and threaten to destroy the natural way. With reverence, with virtue, you must claim his mask and mend the threads of time. Will you walk the path with pride? Sweet winds, Lorkaj's black heart, light to follow, and darkness to thwart. Cunning and strength, virtue and pride, may they prove worthy of mask divine. The way is opened, and so Tidali's part in this ends. It is up to you now, Dragon Guard.
Our first trial. Looks like we'll have to find a way across. Those poles certainly look like grappling points, don't they? Perhaps that's how we make our way across the cavern. Or should I say that's how you make your way across the cavern? We only have the one. A grappling bow, of course. I confiscated this one from Zaji back in Senchal, but I forgot to return it to Sai Sahan. It's pretty easy to use. Just aim, shoot, and hold on tight. We just have to hope there's another path. When you reach the other side, look for anything out of the ordinary. A lever to pull or something to light. Anything that may help me traverse the chasm as well.
Whatever you did, it worked. The door just opened. I'll meet you on the other side. Good work. Now let's see if we can find that mask.
Grandmother Tadali said you had to find light in darkness. Why don't you try igniting the braziers?
beating of the heart. The mirror calls us, walkers!
Lanterns by the shrine. Seems like we're on the right path. Only two more to go.
Ready?
south.
I can feel it pounding in my skull. Can't you hear it?
All four of the shrines. I bet the door will open.
Sliding stones. Casca told me about these. You move them onto panels to unlock gates.
Thank you.
Huh?